Well, this is almost the last of your things, Mrs. Spaulding.
Yeah, looks like it. Could you check the office, see if there's any Beacon files?
Yes, yes, of course.
Has my doctor called about a prescription refill yet?
Not as far as I know.
Make sure that everyone knows where to find me when the call comes in, okay?
Yes.
I thought nobody was home right now. I won't be long.
So you're really moving?
Told you I was.
Why aren't you staying?
What, with Alan? Yeah. You keep proving it over and over again, Philip. You never knew me at all.
Hey, you know what? Let's not do this. Mm-hmm. Because, assuming that you and Alan were going to try to work something out wasn't intended as an insult.
Yeah, what else could it be?
Predictable. Inevitable.
Oh. So since I don't have a shot with you, I should make sure I end up with one of you spelling perks. Is that it? You think anything that either one of you has to offer me is worth this kind of pain? You know what? I've been on my own most of my life, and it's better than being with the wrong person.
Oh, well, I certainly agree with that. And you know what? I really wasn't looking for a fight.
Yeah, well, neither was I.
Good.
Unless you want to fight for me. Because that's what we should be doing. We should be fighting for each other.
Let me tell you something, Olivia. When I got to the Beacon and I found you and Alan together, I was so angry.
Look, I don't...
Hang on a second. Let me finish this. I was angry, and I was hurt, because you hadn't waited. I felt like, I really did feel like you had just jumped into the sack with my father because I was late. I know that. I know that's not true. I know what you thought. But what I realized afterwards is that I was the one that had crossed the line. Think about it. I'm standing in this room with you and my father, and I'm angry with you because you're sleeping with your husband. No, I'm the one that's wrong. I'm the one that crossed the line when I slept with you, because that's not who I am.
It's a nice try. You know, I would have believed those words coming out of your mouth a few months ago, but now, after what we shared, tell me again that you think it was wrong, Philip.
It's wrong to sleep with your father's wife.
That's not what
That's
I asked.
Exactly.
I never should
what
have been his wife.
Well,
he tricked us then, and he tricked us by taking that letter to keep us apart.
Maybe he did. Maybe he did.
You know that he did. You knew in about 10 seconds. He kept that letter away from you to keep us apart.
We don't know that. For
we
sure.
don't.
You know what? It doesn't matter.
What do you mean it doesn't matter? Wait a minute. Are you saying that if you had gotten the letter and Alan hadn't interfered, that we would have ended up right here, just like this?
I can't tell you what if. I can only tell you what happened.
You're feeling guilty over a man who hasn't earned it, Philip. Not one bit of your loyalty.
But see, you don't understand. Those things aren't about him. They're about me and who I am and want to be. It's got nothing to do with him or
but
anybody else.
Who do you
want to
be? Who do you want to be now? Do you want to be a man who loves with everything that he has and then fights for it because he believes
let's
in
not,
it?
Let's not do this. Because we can't change anything.
No, I guess we can't.
Right. I'll leave it to your pack.
The rest of the things are in the car, and this just arrived for you.
Thanks. Mm-hmm. I'll send along a forwarding address as soon as I have one.
Yeah, you can you give it to me. I take care of all the mail.
You take care of all the mail?
Yes, I do.
Hmm.
I'll make sure.
So, did you sign for an overnight letter for me when I was in San Gemara, Nolan? It was addressed to Philip.
I don't recall.
Really? Well, I think that the delivery company probably could. You know, they keep records of those sorts of things. When things arrived and who signed for them.
I remember. I remember something.
You did it. I mean, you were following Ellen's orders, but you intercepted that letter. You tampered with my mail, and now everyone's lives are hell because of it.
Ma'am, I assure you, I never intended
on... intended anything, but that hasn't stopped this from becoming a nightmare, has it? But we're gonna stop that. And you are gonna help me fix it.
Expect, or you think, happened.
I'll save it, Nolan, I know. But Philip doesn't believe it. And since it was his letter that you tampered with, I think he has a right to know. And it'll be easier if it comes from you.
All I do is follow orders.
And that's all I want you to tell him. He'll understand that. Because you did purposely keep that letter from Philip because Alan asked you to, didn't you?
This is not part of my job description.
What isn't? Tampering with the mail or getting nailed for it? Do you know what a horrible mess you've made of things?
Yes. Yes, I do know. I didn't mean to. Anyway, unless there's anything else you need from me, I'll put these things in the car.
Can't get away fast enough.
Don't count me out yet, Alex.
Oh, no, what happened?
I'm gonna nail your brother to the wall because I have proof that Alan purposely intercepted that letter to keep Philip and me apart. And once Philip realizes that, he won't feel guilty about anything and we can fix this mess.
So you're off to tell Philip the good news, huh?
You know what? I don't want you to interfere. I'm sick and tired of people interfering.
I wouldn't dream of it. Go run to Philip. Please do. I mean, what are you gonna do when that doesn't work either?
Philip hates his father's games as much as I do. Once he realizes what Alan
did... Oh, yes, what? He will come back to you? Hmm? Maybe it'll slow Alan down enough to think for a change. I welcome that. And then what? What? You and Philip, you go off in a blaze of righteous indignation? Both turn your back on Alan. And it won't last. It can't.
You don't know that.
I know, Philip. And you're always going to be the woman that... was his father's, the woman he stole, and worse than that, you're the woman who played Alan's games.
No, Philip knows how devious his father can be. He'll understand.
He's never going to accept anyone who's caught up in that wheel. Philip has stayed outside of it. That's the only way he's managed to retain any relationship with Alan at all. You know, before you came along, he was beginning to make some headway with it. He was beginning to understand Alan, accept him for what he was. Accepted for what he was, knew what to expect from him. He was almost happy with his father. Maybe that doesn't sound like much to you, but one of Philip's major demons all along has been his relationship with Alan, hating him and yet desperately needing some peace with him. And he was there. He had some peace. And then you came along. And every time he looks at you, every day from now on, he's going to know what he's missed, what he had. And you're going to know what you cost him, something he wanted more than anything. Oh, that doesn't sound like paradise to
me. You're wrong. You couldn't be more wrong.
No, you'd like me to be wrong. That's not the same thing. Now, if you really love Philip, really love Philip the way you say, do you want to take that chance?
No. You wouldn't know the truth any more than Alan would, and I'm not going to listen to you, not anymore.
Ah, I'm really sick and tired of foie gras. Something lighter. Salmon mousse. Ah, yes. Yes, fine. Please do.
We're having a party?
Yes, right here. celebrating Zach's recovery.
Oh, great. Another opportunity to break bread with the Coopers.
Which includes Goss. Which makes for a very interesting, challenging seating arrangement, since I can't put Gus next to Philip and I cannot put Philip next to you.
Where are you going to put Olivia?
Oh, don't tempt me. Olivia's a non-issue. She's moved out.
Alexandra, Olivia is my wife.
Barely, Alan. And if you want to keep that status quo, you'll stop seeking every opportunity to put her in the same room with Philip.
Philip is not an issue anymore.
Oh, he says, crossing his fingers.
No, I know. And soon she will realize that she needs to be with me permanently.
My, aren't we confident? You know something I don't know?